And there shall be signs in the sun, and in the moon, and in the stars. And upon the earth, distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring, men's hearts failing them for fear, and for looking after those things which are coming on the earth. For the powers of heaven shall be shaken. And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. And he spake to them a parable, Behold the fig tree and all the trees. When they now shoot forth, ye see and know of your own selves that summer is nigh at hand. So likewise ye, when you see these things come to pass, know ye that the kingdom of God is nigh at hand. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass away till all be fulfilled. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away. And take heed to yourself, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and cares of this life, and so that they come upon you unawares. For as a snare shall it come on all them that dwell on the face of the whole earth. Watch ye therefore and pray always, that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man. And in the daytime he was teaching in the temple, and at night he went out in a boat in the mount that is called the Mount of Olives. And all the people came early in the morning to him in the temple to hear him. Luke chapter 21, verses 25 to 38, from the King James Version Bible. The teachings of Jesus Christ are our only safeguard in this chaotic, crisis-filled, catastrophic, calamitous times that all of us are going through, especially here in Southern California at this time. The myriads of problems that are engulfing human beings around the world, this is the moment to reflect, to come to grips with reality, and to realize our need for a Savior, not on a person of or human intervention, but in the personhood of Jesus Christ and divine intervention. Friends, we are living in the edge of judgment. We are on the brink of renewal and the greatest event that will culminate in the second coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the return of our Savior, the promised one in the Bible, is the greatest event that we are all looking forward. Whether you're unbelievers who are not prepared and you're lost, or a believer who is prepared and is saved. Friends, ladies and gentlemen, what is your decision today? May it be that you decide for the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to be on his side against the forces of darkness led by Lucifer, the great liar, the great dragon, the great deceiver of all mankind. So today is a call for true repentance, because his return, the Son of God's return, is imminent. And I believe it with all my heart, because there is just hopelessness all around us in this chaotic times. Case in point, the myriad calamities that are facing the world today, and the human drama that will not be solved by killings, by hatred, by destruction and death, but only will be solved by the mercy and grace and long-suffering of our God, the Son of God the Father, Jesus Christ. I pray, friends, that it will not be too late for you to make the decision today, because the time is at hand. It's an urgent call. Do not be deceived by men. Look back to the Word of God and pray that you will be saved. May God continue to bless you and keep you. This is my prayer.